Technological people, GKV here. Welcome to the fourth video of Next.js fundamental tutorial series. In the last video, we learned what are anonymous functions, what are hooks, and how useState hook works. Now, in this video, we will learn and understand how useEffect hook works and when to use it. I hope you're excited because I sure am. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so I'm back to my VS Code editor. This is where we left in the last video. So what we want to do, we want to understand what is a useEffect hook. I'm going to delete this so that I have more space. And useEffect is a special kind of hook provided by React. It takes two arguments. So the first one is a function. And second one is a list of dependencies. As you might remember from our last video, that this is an anonymous function. If you want, you can pass a named function as well, but this is how it is preferred in the development community, so we gotta keep it this way. So let's see what this means. So what I basically want is I want to run some command. I want to run some logic whenever some event happens. What that event means, that event is defined by this dependency list. For example, if I provide counter here, right? So I'm saying whenever my state variable counter changes, please run this command. So I'm gonna say log. So I'm not doing something very fancy. We're gonna do all of this fancy stuff in next series where we will build a proper project. But to understand the concept, I think this is good enough. What we're gonna do, we're gonna say log console. I was called because counter has changed, right? Okay, let's see this in action. So I'm gonna go back to my Chrome window. I'm gonna clear my console. I'm gonna click on plus button. And you see it says I was called because counter has changed. I can click on plus and it will keep doing the same thing. You can click on minus as well. And you see that it doesn't matter if it's a plus or minus. Whenever the state of this variable changes, this gets logged in the console. So if I refresh the page, notice what happens. It says that I was called because counter has changed, which means that this useEffect function or hook was called one time when we initialize this counter. So let's try something else. I'm gonna say copy. I'm gonna say paste. I'll say counter one. Okay. And here, for the increment, I'm gonna say counter one. I'm not gonna say update counter. I'm just gonna say counter one. So if I go here, and this should also be counter one. Save it. Now if I go back to my browser, I click on plus one. You see nothing happens, and nothing is logged here because the way we have designed our code, we are saying this should only be called when counter is changed. We don't care about counter one. If I click on minus, now you see that this function was called and it changed the counter, and hence this effect was called. So that is one way of using useEffect. This comes handy when you want to do something very specifically when state of a variable changes. There's another way of using useEffect, and that would be without any dependencies in the list. And this will be executed only once when the component is mounted, right? Or say initialized. I save it. And if I go back, if I refresh the page, you will see it says this was executed only once when the component was mounted slash initialized. Now if I press on minus button or plus button, you will see that you will never see this appearing again. Now this could be super useful, for example, in cases when you want to fetch something from a database and display to the user. Or maybe you just want to check if user is logged in. Things like that. Okay? Now there's another way of using useEffect, and I promise this is the last way, or these three are the only ways of doing this, that you do not provide any dependencies. And when you do that, this hook will be called every time this hook will be called every time this component re-renders. And a component re-renders whenever a state variable changes. Now this is important. So note what happens here. If I click on plus, you see that my counter did not change, and you know, no other log effect happened, but we did get this one. This hook will be called every time component re-renders. If I click on minus, this was called because counter was changed, and this hook will be called every time this component re-renders, which means that it doesn't matter which state variable changes, but whenever a state variable changes, useEffect will be called. Alright, I hope this was helpful, and I hope now you understand how useEffect works. And in general, you need to also conceptualize how useEffect works in tandem with useState. Alright, logic lovers, that's all for this video. In the next one, we will learn how to use useRef hook. See you there. And before you click on the next video, do not forget to subscribe and like the video. It definitely motivates me to create more videos for you. Also, you can use the comment section to let me know what other things you would like to learn, and I will try to create those tutorials for you.